inference for two independent means. Before we can start inference, we need to decide if we are using the pooled or unpooled method to calculate the sample variance. We can quickly check for this by computing descriptive statistics. We will first look at the continuous one variable in C5, and it will be broken up into two independent groups using the nominal binary variable in C1. Let's compute the variance for the no's and the variance for the yeses. We can do this in the stat menu by choosing basic statistics, display descriptive statistics. We're looking at the variable continuous one in C5. The by variables is C1, nominal binary. And in the statistics button, we can uncheck everything but variance. Here we can take the ratio of the larger variance to the smaller variance to see if we need to use the pooled or unpooled method. The larger variance is 405.57, and the smaller variance is 332.54. We can see that this ratio is small enough to use the pooled method. We can perform the inference in Minitab by going to the stat menu, basic statistics, to sample T. Right away, I don't want to forget that I'm going to use the pooled method. So I need to check off the box at the bottom that says assume equal variances. Next, we need to understand how the data is presented to us. We have one column of numbers and one column of a binary variable. That means we'll use samples in one column, since our numbers are in one column. Samples is the column with the numbers. That's continuous one. Notice that I cannot choose C1, nominal binary, because it doesn't have numbers in it. Next, for subscripts, that's the column C1, the nominal binary variable. When we click the options button, we can set the confidence level, the test difference, which is the null value, and the alternative hypothesis. Make sure that the alternative hypothesis is set to not equal if you're looking for a confidence interval. The output starts with summary statistics. Then it tells us the order of the differences. Then it tells us the order of the difference. We can see the sample estimate, then the confidence interval. Next, we can see the hypotheses, the test statistic, the p-value, the pooled degrees of freedom, and finally, the pooled standard deviation. let's look at an example using the unpooled method. We'll look at the discrete variable. And we are not going to assume that the population variances for discrete no and discrete yes, using the nominal binary variable, are going to be equal. So since sigma 1 does not equal sigma 2, we will use the unpooled method. We can go back into Stat, Basic Statistics, to Sample T. I will uncheck the Assume Equal Variances box. We still have samples in one column, but this time we're looking at C4, discrete. Nominal binary is still okay. We're still using the no's and the yeses. This time I'd like to create a 99% confidence interval. Once again, the data is summarized first. And then we can look down here for the confidence interval. Or over here for the p-value. Minitab can also handle situations where you have two columns of numerical data. The groups are already broken up. This situation exists in the data set called data 2. We have the continuous 2 variable broken up into no's in C1 and yeses in C2. We can perform a hypothesis test by going to Stat, Basic Statistics, to Sample T. We no longer have samples in one column. This time we'll choose the option Samples in Different Columns. For the first, I chose to enter no, and the second, I chose to enter yes. If I'm doing a two-sided hypothesis test, the order is not going to matter. For this data, we know that the population variances are equal, so I will check off the box Assume Equal Variances. I'll go into Options and change the confidence level. But I'd like to leave the alternative hypothesis as not equal. Once again, the output starts with the summary statistics. Then it shows the order. No's come first, then yeses. Here's the confidence interval. And the p-value.